Hi students, welcome. In today's class we are discussing about cardioid. So cardioid is one type of epicycloids only, clear? So you know that epicycloid is nothing but a rolling wheel rolls on the another wheel, clear? That is called epicycloid. Similar case cardioid also, but only one difference. Normal epicycloid means the rolling wheel and directing wheels are different sizes, but here cardioid is nothing but both are same size. For example, let us consider a die of 40 of size is nothing but rolling wheel size. It rolls on the same die of 40 on directing wheel. So what shape it appears? Clear? That is, the shape is artin shape. So artin shape is nothing but it is a cardioid. Cardiology is not clear, heart specialist, like that. So that shape artin. So how to construct a cardioid? We go for now. Let's go. Let us consider a rolling wheel is nothing but generating wheel. Generating wheel size, let us consider for example die of 40, and it rolls on another wheel. Another wheel is nothing but directing wheel. So directing wheel size also same die of 40. So both are same size, rolling wheel and directing wheel. It's nothing but generating wheel and directing wheel, both are same size. Clear? Very simple. So you know that you draw one axis line, either it is inclined or horizontal or any angle. Okay, choices. So next one is here directing. First you draw the directing wheel of size 40 mm, die of 40, clear? So take radius 20, you draw die of 40, next one, another one also same die of 40. So from here it is starting point. So from here to here again one more die of 40. Let us consider. So this one is directing wheel, another one is rolling wheel. Let us consider that also same diameter. No, so like this, clear? So this one is rolling wheel, this one is directing wheel, both are same size of, let us consider die of 40. Next thing, your rolling wheel divided into n equal parts. So let us consider equal parts, therefore 45 degree, clear? That's one. So the starting point P here. So already you know that the default, the direction is not given, means let us consider clockwise direction. Okay, and the starting point P always meeting of two wheels. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 equal parts are there. So not only 8 equal parts, you go for 12 equal parts also, clear? So next thing, you determine the theta. You know well the theta value, so r by r into 360, or otherwise small d divided by caps d divided by 360. So here die of 40 means radius 20, another one also radius 20, therefore 360, we get total 360 degree. Therefore you want to draw a 360 degree curve, concentric curve. Clear? It's nothing but circle. So therefore you draw that. So this is O1 center, this is O2 center. O1 to P already is there. Next to O1 to 1 as the radius, you draw O1 as the center, O1 to 1 as the radius, you draw one circle. Clear? This one. Next to O1 to, definitely the O1 to 1 radius curve is passing through number 7 also. Next to O1 to 2 as the radius, you draw one another concentric curve. Clear? Next, O12, free. It definitely is passing through number 5. Next, O124. You want to, so the circle, how many equal parts? The rolling wheel circle you are divided into 8 equal parts. Therefore, the concentric circle also, the 360 degree also, you want to divide it into same 8 equal parts. Therefore, that also 45 degree each. So, here already 4 equal parts is there. Again, 45 degree means we get 8 here also, clear. I understand. And next, one more circle is missing. It's nothing but locus center. So O1 to O2 as the radius, you draw center point method, that is center line. Like this. So next, that 8 equal parts of that line, when it is intersecting, it is starting one. So this is center, it is center 1, here center 2, this one center 3, center 4, C5, C6, C7, as it is C8. Next, as usual, what are the size? You know well, the rolling wheel, in this problem both are same size, therefore radius how much? 20. So 20 as the radius, C1 as the center, intersect arc on that number 1 curve. So let us consider 20 as the radius, C1 as the center, intersect arc on that number 1. Next, C2 as the center, intersect arc on that number 2, P1, P2. C3 as the center, intersect arc on that number 3, like this. Here. Next, C4, we get top mole, P4. Next, here, like this, it is P5. Next, C6 as the center, intersect arc here, and sixth line, so 2, 6, same. Next, C7, same, or it is number 1 and 7 here, intersecting here. So, P1, P2, P3, P4, P5, P6, P7, and N. So now you join all the curves, intersecting points. Finally, we get epicycloidal curve. That curve shape, it appears heart in shape, cardioid. Clear. So starting point here, draw the curve, and ending also here. So like this. Perfectly by using proper instruments, it appears that one. It appears heart like this. Clear? So this is cardioid. Clear? Same procedure. Ditto 100% same procedure for HEPI also. Only one difference, the size. In this case, both the size are same. Rolling wheel size diaphragm and directing wheel size diaphragm, therefore we get 360 degree. Clear? Okay, students, so this is the procedure how to draw a cardioid. It is one type of epicycloid. Clear? We go for in another video in another special course. Okay, thank you.